The work of Nobel laureate Harry Markowitz in the early 1950s triggered a revolution in investment management. The concepts of efficient portfolio and efficient frontier are key in modern finance. The basic idea is that investors should select portfolios that offer the highest return for the least amount of risk. Through diversification among several securities, we can reduce risk. The portfolio risk is lower than the combined risks of the constituents. We can classify every portfolio along the axes of risk and return. An efficient portfolio is any portfolio that has a minimal amount of risk for a given return. Or the other way round, the highest expected return for a risk level. The line that connects these portfolios in a risk-return graph is the efficient frontier. Although Markowitz focused on securities, his novel theories have found their way into bank lending. For a bank, the biggest asset is the loan portfolio. An investor looks for an optimal combination of risk and return in creating a portfolio of securities. This is also true for a financial institution. A bank wants to extend loans to those industries that maximize return for a given level of risk. The problem boils down to the sector breakdown of the loan portfolio. What is the ideal composition of a loan portfolio? In this video, we will explain how to approach this problem using the Excel Solver add-in. Make sure you have this add-in installed. If not, you can enable Solver under Options. Let's take a look at a simple example for a bank with 10,000 monetary units to allocate to its loan portfolio. The current portfolio allocation over the three industrial sectors, A, B, and C, is 20%, 20%, and 60%. For each of the sectors, we can calculate the exposure. We also know the expected profit margin. Due to variances in the loan losses, these margins are surrounded by uncertainty. This risk equals the standard deviation of the expected margin. We often use the lowercase Greek letter, sigma, to refer to this risk. To make things more comprehensive, we will calculate with both percentages as well as with monetary units. The loans in our portfolio are correlated. The correlation matrix shows these correlations. Usually, we use the lowercase Greek letter, rho, to refer to correlations. We notice that there is a strong positive correlation between the sectors. The goal of our exercise is to find the portfolio composition that, given a certain risk level, yields the highest return. To carry out this optimization, we need to know the portfolio yield and the portfolio risk. The margin or yield is simple. We multiply for each sector the exposure with the margin and we find the totals in the last column. So, our margin on our 10,000 loan portfolio is 183 monetary units, or 1.83%. Calculating the risk or standard deviation is more difficult. Here we need to do a matrix multiplication to get the standard deviation of the portfolio margin. We will show how to perform this calculation. In another video, we have explained this calculation in more detail. We already saw the correlation matrix. To make the calculation easier, we assign a name to the matrix. We call this matrix, rho. Now, we must create a second matrix in which we put the standard deviations along the diagonal axis. We did this in monetary units, but of course it is also possible to do this in percentages. We multiply the standard deviation with the exposure for each of the sectors. Make sure to fill the rest of the matrix with zeros. We assign the name, sigma, to this matrix. We need to multiply these matrices to get the variance-covariance matrix in the following way. Variance-covariance matrix equals sigma matrix times rho matrix times sigma matrix. Excel has a function MMULT to perform the matrix multiplication. Variance-covariance equals MMULT, MMULT, sigma, rho, sigma. The result is a third matrix. A nice feature of this matrix is that the sum of its cells equals the portfolio variance. The square root of the variance provides the portfolio standard deviation. So, for our current portfolio, the standard deviation equals 16.33 or 0.1633%. This represents the risk associated with our current portfolio. The bank or FI needs to decide which risk level is acceptable given its profile and capital buffers. We call this risk level the risk appetite. Let's assume that the board has set this risk appetite. A standard deviation on the portfolio margin of 0.14% is the maximum acceptable risk level. Now the challenge is to find a portfolio composition that yields the highest margin for this risk level. It is a classical optimization problem. Excel Solver is the tool to use. We open Solver and start filling out the references. First, we set the objective. We refer to the total margin and of course we would like to maximize this amount. Next step is to define the variables that need to be optimized to get the optimal result. Here we refer to the industry sector percentages of our portfolio. After all, we are looking for the best composition of our portfolio. Then we define the constraints. We put a ceiling to the standard deviation of 0.14% or 14 monetary units. We included this ceiling in our model. The standard deviation calculated through the matrix multiplication exercise should stay under this ceiling we set. This we define under constraints. There is a second constraint. The portfolio percentages should add up to 100% or to 1. Now we are good to go and can run our optimization. Solver returns the best portfolio composition given the risk appetite set by the financial institution. We copy these percentages from Solver into the spreadsheet. The maximum margin at this risk level is 169.70 monetary units or 1.70%. From the above it is clear that if we set a different risk level, we will get a different portfolio composition and a different return. In general, the return will be higher if we are willing to accept more risk. So, relaxing the standard deviation ceiling will lead to a higher margin. Similarly, if we lower the risk ceiling, the margin will decrease. We could repeat our solver exercise for a series of different standard deviations. In the Excel spreadsheet we have done this for 9 data points for standard deviation between 0.12% and 0.20%. We see the results in the table. The portfolio composition changes as we change the risk appetite for our financial institution. In the most risk-averse scenario, our portfolio consists mainly of loans to sector B, while in the riskiest scenario we only lend to sector C. The bar graph shows the portfolio composition at each risk level. Here is our answer as to what the best portfolio is. As the financial institution has defined its risk appetite, we can see what the corresponding ideal portfolio would look like. We can show the relationship between the risk appetite and margin in a graph. We see that the graph is upward sloping. More risk leads to higher returns. We call this graph the efficient frontier. The line combines the best possible or portfolios for each risk level. Thanks for watching and good luck.